Body is the manifest form and being, the light that is still behind the horizon, is the unmanifest form. Both visible and invisible stay together. It is the harmony of the visible and invisible, manifest and unmanifest, that creates inner balance and begins the journey. And inner balance manifests itself in the outer realm. Out of this inner balance bursts the fragrance of the being of the soul. You can be this fragrance, and then something will spring forth from within. Both body and soul are the part of one harmony. They are part of one whole. First, this comes to you. And then you begin to understand that there is no difference between the drop and the ocean. Drop is infinitesimal and ocean is whole, but qualitatively the drop and the ocean are the same. You understand the nature of sex energy. Its transcendence begins. Knowledge comes. And when you understand this, that sex is the seed, then love is the flower that blossoms on the tree. When the seed of sex blossoms, the seed completely disappears. If the seed wants to remain as a seed, there will be no growth. There will be no flowering. When seed disappears, dissolves in the womb of the earth, there is constant nourishment. It grows into a tree. The tree, when the season of the bloom comes, there are myriad blossoms as flowers, and love is that blossom. Love begins with lust, love begins with sex energy, but it has nothing of that. And you can envision that there is a continuity between the seed and the flowering. This seed has blossomed into a flower. You are climbing up on the higher ladder. When love begins to blossom, you develop the wings. Patience and trust are the two wings. Patience and trust are the two wings. You cannot expect or force the flower of love to blossom. It has to blossom on its own. When you constantly nourish the seed with your awareness, with your understanding, then one day the seed blossoms into a flower. Now, its beauty and the fragrance are two things. Before the beauty and the fragrance disappear, you have to allow these to happen. Allow these to become patience and trust. When patience and trust comes, the seed vanishes, the knowledge that was necessary is no more. You attain to the state of devotion, which Hindus call as bhakti. Bhakti is far superior than love. Love as such can be directed towards the objects and beings. Love can be directed towards an unknown source. As such, your love is directed towards the objects and beings. And when love's direction is changed, it is directed towards an unknown and unknowable one. There comes a harmony. You don't, at the physical level, at the level where you are, you don't need the spouse. The orchestra is tuned, whether your beloved is around you or not, but you do not miss him. There is a harmony, there is oneness, the orchestra is tuned, and you are enjoying the bliss, the music that is overflowing out of that tuning of the instruments. And when it is directed towards an unknown, an unknowable, that we call as God, that we call it as Rab, we call it by different names, then it becomes a bhakti or devotion. Then with patience and trust, then faith is not needed. Religion is left far behind. Knowledge is left far behind. All these are irrelevant. They are the temporary stopping points on the way when you are moving from the lower to the higher. You are traveling from one place to another to reach to the highest abode. All these are the ways. When you reach to the highest, you have to abandon all that. Sufis say, you have to abandon in the first stage, tark-e-tark, you have to abandon reasoning. With the reasoning, the knowledge is abandoned. Then you have to abandon all religion and all that. The desire for the other world, the religion, the knowledge, all that comes in the realm of reasoning, tark. You have to abandon that. That I am a Hindu, I am a Muslim, I am a Christian. Ocean never says I am the water of Thames, Hudson, or Ganges, or any other. Hindus consider Ganges as the holy water. But ocean does not claim that I am the holy water from Ganges. All the waters lose their individuality into the when they merge into the ocean. So you are no more Hindu, no more Christian, no more, not identified by any of these things. Your essential nature, your essential religion is bliss. To experience that, to live in that, to manifest, to continue to float in that, that bliss then becomes the placenta where you constantly dwell and move around. You have developed the wings, patience, that is dharya, and trust. Trust is not faith. Faith has the aspect of mind into it. Trust is an aspect of heart, is a functioning of heart. Out of that, bhakti is born in you. Bhakti means devotion. Love, which has no element of lust or anything in it. It is freed from all that. That flows irresistibly. Even if you want to make an effort not to flow, but it flows. Then you don't need to give it to your spouse anything. And that kind of love, when it is directed towards the spouse, it becomes paramount. And we call this relationship as paramount. And we call this as not something which is not acceptable, but it is a word that comes from two words, para and amor. Par, that is beyond. Amor is love. Par, amor. Love that is beyond all knowings. Love that is beyond all that is known. And that kind of selfless love is reflected through the lives of Krishna and Radha. The lover does not seek anything from the beloved. Beloved does not seek anything from the lover. They are tuned and flow and continuously flowing, and they play one music, the harmony. Then you get the wings of trust and patience and constantly fly in the horizon, constantly dwell in that. This is the ultimate that one has to attain to. And when that state comes, the turbulent of sex is no more. There is clarity of the vision. There is no confusion of the memory. Anger, lust, greed, all that is transformed into love, and you become like an ocean, equipoised. Equanimity comes. You remain unmovable under all circumstances and situations. You understand the very nature of the world, its dualities, and you are not affected by it. This state in yoga is called a state of sthit pragya. Sthit means a state of equanimity. And that is, then nothing disturbs you. The very purpose of Tantra is to take you to that state through various methods so that you can understand the basic existential energy, allow it to move, and you develop an understanding, and then the process attains fruition. And if it does not happen, then the process has not yet begun, or you are in the journey. You realize totality alone is. Feel it within. Feel its harmony and its rhythm as well. Life moves in a totally different way.